This session, participants of this conference. Good evening. I'm Dr. Susila, working as senior scientist in medicine and aromatic plants association, Hyderabad. Now I'm going to present my work on effect of different plant densities on leaf and gel yield of aloe barbadensis. Aloe is one among the few medicinal plants by virtue of its extensive medicinal, nutraceutical, cosmetic uses enjoy a major chunk of the market across the world. There are over 250 species of aloe grown around the world, and aloe can be grown in warm tropical areas and cannot survive freezing temperatures. Aloe can be found in Mexico, the Pacific Rim countries, India, South America, Central America, the Caribbean, Australia, and Africa. World trade of aloe is worth about $80 million, and this is likely to increase by 35 to 40% in the next 5 years. USA dominates the market with 65% share, while India and China have a share of 10% each. It is an important drug of the Indian systems of medicine, particularly in Ayurveda and Yunani. In Sanskrit, it is called Kumari because it imparts youthfulness and enhances the femininity. The gel contains glucosides, that is barbaloin, isobarbaloin, and beta-barbaloin. The gel also contains glucose, galactose, galactouric acid, mannose, and eleusine. Pharmacologically, it is an immunobooster and detoxifies the system. It is recommended in adjuvant therapy with antibiotics, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and chemotherapy to eliminate drug-induced gastritis and other adverse effects. Usefulness in various diseases such as type 2 diabetes, arthritis, eye diseases, spleen enlargement, liver complaints, bronchitis, asthma, and also in jaundice. It also relieves constipation, helps in inflammatory bowel disease, non-ulcer dyspepsia, gastric and duodenal ulcers. The gel is an effective appetizer, digestant, liver stimulant, and it is very useful as a blood purifier, hence it is very valuable in skin diseases. Aloein is known as the main active component of aloe preparations, and it has generally been used as a key component for the quality control of pharmaceuticals containing aloe. Beginning in the 1950s, aloe vera gel has gained respect as a commodity used as a base for nutritional drinks, as a moisturizer, and a healing agent in cosmetics and in OTC drugs. The cultivation of aloe has acquired great commercial importance for medicinal products and cosmetics processing, but information is very scarce about the agronomic management of this crop. The experiment was conducted during the year 2010-11 at our research station, that is Medicinal and Aromatic Plants Research Station, Hyderabad. And I have taken 12 treatments. A number of replications were 3, and it was conducted in factorial randomized block design. I have taken 2 factors. One is 2 different varieties of aloe vera. One is aloe flowering, orange flowering type, another one is yellow flowering type. And another factor is spacing. I have taken 6 spacings. One is 45 into 45 centimeters, 60 into 45 centimeters, 60 into 60 centimeters, 75 into 30 centimeters, 75 into 60 centimeters, and 75 into 75. These are the different spacings where I have adapted for planting of aloe. And this graph shows the uniform cultural operations were followed for all the treatments. It was planted during the month of July. Usually aloe takes for first harvesting about 10 months. Later, for every 3 months, we usually would take another harvest. I had taken the first harvest at the age of 10 months. Now I am giving the harvest data. I have recorded the data on leaf length, leaf width, number of leaves per plant, weight of the each leaf and the gel weight of the each leaf, and the yield per plant and yield per hectare. This slide shows the average length of the aloe vera leaf at different harvests. This slide, during the first harvest, the average length of the leaf is around 40 centimeters. Whereas in third harvester, the leaf length goes to 50 to 52 centimeters, and there is no significant difference in between the two varieties with reference to the leaf length. This is the slide shows the effect of spacing on leaf length in a row at different harvests. Here also there is no significant difference in between the spacings, different spacings with reference to the aloe vera leaf length. The average leaf length recorded during the first harvest, the range is in between 39.59 to 42.23 centimeters. During second harvest, the leaf length is 45.39 to 48.9 centimeters. During third harvest, the average leaf length is 49.52 to 53.95 centimeters. The slide shows the average width of the aloe vera leaf at different harvests. Here also, the leaf width, there is no significant difference between the two varieties with reference to this leaf width. However, the leaf width during first harvest is very around 6.64 to 6.8 centimeters, whereas in third harvest, the leaf size, because of increase in leaf size, the leaf width goes to 8.38 to 8.45 centimeters. This slide shows the effect of spacing on leaf width in aloe. Here also there is no significant difference in between different spacings with reference to leaf width. The range of the leaf width during first harvest is 6.43 to 6.93 centimeters. In second harvest, the range is in between 7 to 7.667. In the third harvest, it is 8.28 to 8.5 centimeters. This slide shows the number of leaves harvested per plant in aloe at different harvests. There is a significant difference in between the two varieties with reference to number of leaves harvested per plant. During harvesting, yellow flowering type produces more number of the leaves. Even it continues in the second harvest and third harvest also. In the third harvesting, the yellow flowering type produced 8.94 leaves per plant, whereas orange flowering type produced less number of the leaves. This is the effect of spacing on number of leaves harvested per plant. Here, there is no significant difference in between the different spacings with reference to number of leaves per plant harvested. However, the average number, the range is in between 4.7 to 5.76 in the first harvesting. In the second harvesting, it is 5.5 to 6.26. In the third harvesting, it is 7.1 to 8.43. Here the average leaf weight in aloe at a different harvest. There is a significant difference in leaf weight in orange flowering type produced during first harvesting and second harvesting. It has produced more weight of the leaves. Whereas in the third harvesting, yellow flowering type dominated the growth and it has produced more weight of the leaves. During first harvesting, the average leaf weight recorded is 268 grams in orange flowering type. In the second harvesting also, this orange flowering type produced higher leaf weight. It is 412 grams of weight. Whereas in third harvesting, yellow flowering type produced higher leaf weight when compared to the orange flowering type. This is effect of spacing and average leaf weight in aloe. During the first harvesting, there is no significant difference in average weight of the leaf. Whereas in second harvesting onwards, there is a significant difference in between the different spacings. Maximum leaf weight was recorded in S6. The average leaf weight is higher in S6 spacing. That it is 75 into 75 centimeters planted plants. At that plant spacing, the plants produced more higher leaf weight when compared to the S1, where the spacing is 45 into the much closer spacing. Similarly, in third harvesting also, S6 spacing, the average leaf weight is higher. It is around 557.5 grams. This slide shows the average gel weight. We have collected the gel weight from each leaf on an average from 5 plants. During first harvesting, the average gel weight is higher in orange flowering type. It is 168.60 grams. Even during second harvesting also, orange flowering type gave higher gel weight. whereas in third harvesting the gel weight is higher in our yellow flowering type. This is mainly because the leaf weight is higher in the third harvesting in yellow flowering type. That's why automatically it has given higher gel weight in the third harvesting. This is the effect of spacing on average gel weight per leaf at different harvests. During first harvest and the second harvest, there is no significant difference in average gel weight in between the spacings. But during third harvest, S6 plants planted in S6 produced higher gel weight when compared to the plants planted at closer spacing in S1 or whatever it is in S2. In the S6, the average gel weight per plant per leaf was 338.5 grams, whereas in S1 it is 210 grams. Per leaf. This is the yield per plant in yellow varieties at different harvests. During first harvesting, the average yield per plant is higher in yellow flowering type. It is 658 grams per plant, whereas in second harvest also, yellow flowering plant produced higher leaf yield per plant. It is 1.28 kg. In third harvesting also, the trend continued, and the yield per plant in third harvesting in yellow flowering type is 3.6 kg. This is effect of spacing on leaf yield per plant in yellow. The maximum yield per plant was recorded in S6 because of more leaf weight in this treatment. The average yield per plant is also higher. The same trends was continued in the second harvesting also. In third harvesting also the average yield per plant was highest in S6. This is yield per hectare in different harvests, and also I have calculated cumulatively yield in the three harvests. During first harvesting, the yield per hectare is higher in yellow flowering type. It is 12.7 tons per hectare. In the second harvest, it is 15.76 in this yellow flowering type. The trend is also continued in the third harvest. In third harvesting, yellow flowering type produced 55 tons per hectare. And the cumulative yield is also highest in yellow flowering type. It is 96.81 tons per hectare in this variety. This is effect of spacing on leaf yield at different harvests and cumulative leaf yield. This highest yield was recorded in the third harvest. It is 71.64 tons per hectare in S1. The maximum yield in this treatment is because of more number of plants in this treatment. Even though the average leaf weight is highest in S6, because per unit area, the number of plants in per unit area is less. That's why it has recorded less yield. Whereas number of plants per unit area were higher in this S1 treatment, that's why it has recorded higher yield. In the first harvest, the average yield recorded in this S1 is 19.32 tons, whereas in the second harvest, it is 21.25 tons. In the third harvest, it is 71.64 tons per hectare. And cumulative yield is also highest in this treatment. It is 111 tons per hectare. This is interaction effect of spacing and aloe varieties on leaf yield during third harvest. During third harvest, the yellow flowering type when planted at the 45 into 45 centimeters produced the highest yield. It is 89.26 tons per hectare. This is interaction effect of spacing and aloe varieties on cumulative leaf yield per hectare. Here also, planting of aloe yellow flowering type at a spacing of 45 into 45 centimeters produced maximum yield. It is 137.47 tons per hectare. Coming to the conclusions, among the two varieties of aloe studied, number of leaves per plant were highest in yellow flowering type. No significant influence of spacing was observed on number of leaves per plant. Average leaf weight was highest in orange flowering type during first and second harvesting, while in third harvesting, yellow flowering type recorded maximum leaf weight. During first harvesting, influence of spacing on leaf weight has not observed, while in second and third harvesting, highest leaf weight was observed when aloe was planted at 75 into 75 centimeter spacing. The average gel weight per leaf was highest in orange flowering type during first and second harvesting, and during third harvesting, yellow flowering type produced higher gel content per leaf. No significant influence of spacing and gel weight per leaf was observed during first and second harvesting, while during third harvesting, highest gel weight was produced in plants planted at 75 × 75 cm spacing. Yield per plant during first and second and third harvest were highest in yellow flowering type. Yellow flowering type produced highest yield in all the harvests when it was planted at 75 × 75 cm spacing. Among the two varieties of aloe, yellow flowering type produced highest yield per hectare in all the harvests. Even the cumulative yield per hectare was also highest in this variety. And among the different spacing studied, aloe when planted at a spacing of 45 × 45 cm produced highest yield. It is about 111 tons per hectare. Regarding interaction, planting of yellow flowering type at a spacing of 45 × 45 cm produced highest yield of 137.47 tons per hectare. Thank you, sir.